Welcome to Storyboard. I'm Shivani Gharat. In a special chat, I'm catching up with Essence Media Comms APAC CEO Rupert McPetree. He was visiting India this week. It was just a year ago that Group M's newest and largest agency, Essence Media Comms, was formally launched with an ambition to deliver marketing breakthroughs for their clients. In APAC, this one-year-old agency is led by Rupert and it recruits more than 2,500 people across 29 offices in 16 markets in the region. On the show this week, Rupert is sharing their one-year report card, India expectations and much more. Let's take a look. So Rupert, you are leading the newest agency under Group M, which is Essence Media Comms, which was formally launched last year. What has been the past 1 year report card been like for Essence Media Comms in APAC?
Sure. Look, it's been, for me, an extraordinary last 12, 18 months. I say to the team often, I think actually I've got the best job in the world, because to your point, I'm running, you know, the world's leading, I'd say, one of the strongest, one of the best agencies, most new and fresh agencies in Group M, and I'd say in the sector. And the last 12 months in particular, after we launched, has been one of really trying to get out, see clients with our new offer. This whole idea of, you know, as the landscape changes for consumers, the landscape changes, media, platforms, there's a real opportunity to find growth, to find new channels, new customers, if you can understand and map that ecosystem. That ecosystem is what we call the new communications economy. So Essence Media Comms, after we launched back in 2023, has all been about taking this new proposition around the new communications economy to our client partners and to the wider businesses, and really showing how the work we do, understanding that ecosystem, can deliver growth, or what we call breakthrough. So it's been a terrific journey.
You're in particular, for the agency business, if you see and if you look at it, has been a year of consolidation, so to speak. So many consolidations have happened. Being there, being in the thick of the things, you know, living through, merging of Essence and MediaCom. How do you look at it? What were some of the key learnings out of that experience? What were some of the challenges bringing together these two diverse entities, specifically in the region, with diverse cultures of their own?
So there are a number of key learnings, I guess. Number one is, you know, you really, really need to take care of people. You know, sometimes as businesses, we articulate a beautiful plan and vision, but the people who deliver the vision are the staff, the team members, the people that work with clients every day. So we really need to take care of people through the process. You know, change creates uncertainty, even if it's a positive change. So we need to take care of the people. We did a lot of work around taking care of the teammates, colleagues, what we call essentials all around the world, and particularly here in APAC. So that's number one. I think number two is how you communicate. You need to share information. As soon as you announce a merger, as soon as you announce a new agency, the industry is asking questions, clients are asking questions.
Correct. And happened globally beforehand, sure, before hitting the APAC market, right?
Yeah, I mean, we tried to do it in one, but inevitably the questions start coming from everywhere. Mm. So you need to start communicating very quickly. Mm. Maybe you haven't got 100% of the answer, but avoid the silences, right? You need to just come out, share what you can, talk about the direction, talk about the timelines. So that's probably number two. Number three, you want to do it properly. So that means consulting lots of stakeholders, going through process, making sure the plan is good. But again, as soon as you announce, you create expectation. And if it is a new offer, if it is something differentiated, then clients want to get to what's new very quickly, yeah, as the prospect, and what people want to know. So we tended to find this, I guess, a little bit of a tension of wanting to do things steadily, progressively, according to the plan, but also move very quickly. And look, in APAC as well, all the markets tend to move super fast, right? Because of all the changes that we see on the ground. Sure. So it's, people, communication, and speed, I guess.
Great. So Essence Media Comms is the largest, media investment agency under Group M today. Tell us some of the insights which are specific for the region as compared to, like, you know, the global markets.
One of the things that is extraordinarily exciting about the region is that diversity. And I mean diversity from every lens that you can look at it, you know, culture, consumers, landscape, platform, the rate of change in all of those. You know, the region moves quickly, but in a way, a different pace in different territories. And so I think, you know, for us in particular in APAC, that created special opportunity when we did move fast. You know, I think our positioning around navigating the new communications economy is more relevant in APAC probably than anywhere else. And why do I say that? It's because you look at different parts of the region, look at, you know, social media moving through to social commerce. You know, you look at the incredible changes that went in, back in China a couple of years ago, that then go into Indonesia, into India. You know, look at mobile penetration, smartphone penetration, transforming the way that customers, potential customers, engage with brands.
Rupert, from you, I need to understand the significance of India market for Essence Mediacom, and what will be your key focus areas going forward in the country?
So it's a year of change. There's lots of elections. There's lots of economic things going on. So then when you look at the potential for growth, you look at GDP, you know, published GDP for India looks very promising for 2024. You look at the ADEX, probably running at 2 times that forecast in 2024. And that's an indicator not just of the vibrancy of the economy, but the high level of interest and opportunity that customers, our clients see, businesses see, to grow their businesses from a volume, not only share point of view, in the market. So there's a lot of advertiser attention here, and for good reason. I mean, you look at the stats in terms of overall population, the emergent middle class, you look at the tech penetration, digital handset penetration. You know, again, you've got this confluence of really interesting vectors that suddenly think, wow, this, you know, if you're going to place a big bet anywhere in 2024, it would be here in India.
So what are your expectations? What are some of the tasks earmarked for the team in the country?
So since Nick was here, Naveen and the team have done a brilliant job, honestly. India's been a real, you know, shining star globally for Essence Mediacom in year one. And, you know, you can look at the scorecard on that around, you know, the clients that we're working with, the new clients that we've grown and taken on board in the last 12 months here. But I think more importantly, you look at some of the couple of other areas that we've worked on, one of which is the people side. Just to really take more care of our people, give them more learning and development opportunities, growth opportunities, I guess. And the outcome of all of that is the work. And the work that has come out of this business in India has been terrific in the last 12 months. You know, Cannes award-winning, all the different festivals, including local festivals, you know, Goa Fest, MVs recently, and then on the global stage. So really good recognition of the work the last 12 months. So what's next? What's next, I think, is much more consistent application of that excellence. You know, I don't want it to just be one Cannes winner, right? I'd like us to at least enter more. And not just for the fame that comes for that. But, you know, we look at advertising not just as a vehicle for growth for our clients, but also an opportunity to effect change in the communities that we work in, the societies that we operate in.
So
some of the work that comes
winner,
in.
Cannes winner. Then, apart from that, what else?
Well,
new client pipeline, maybe?
New client pipeline is exciting. Team's had a terrific first 2 months to the year. So I'm obviously encouraging them to do more. I said to Naveen, you know, the problem when you hit a target is the target gets bigger. So, you know, the ambition for the business is high for this year. So work, growth from new clients. But look, I also think as we pivot on the landscape where, you know, e-commerce is becoming so much more scale here, again, digital penetration, very
keeps
high.
It's increasing.
So the type of solutions we bring to clients needs to reflect that more and more. And not just one client, one market, but much more consistent approach to how we navigate that new economy and how we can draw a closer line of sight between what we do on behalf of clients and the business outcomes that they have. So those three things, right?
It is time for a short break. On the other side, we are catching up with Cleartrip CEO Ayappan Rajagopal.